Thank you. swearing a death bell in front. God, Jesus says, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me shall live. And he who dies and believes in me, they shall live. The Lord gives, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going to prepare a place for you.
Great is thy faithfulness, O God, my Father. car and left it, I'll get it in a shop. I'm so sorry for the embarrassing anyone.
This is the day that the Lord hath made. In spite of the circumstances, we still give him honor and glory. In the midst of life, there is death. And in the midst of death, the Lord promises eternal life. This morning we are gathered to celebrate a life and to continue living to the glory of God. Let us pray. Great is thy faithfulness, O God. Morning by morning, new mercies we see. All we have ever needed, thy hands have provided. Great is thy faithfulness to us. Almighty God and our Father, the loving and kind name of Jesus the Christ, we bow ourselves before thee this Friday morning. Morning, O God, that you have alone to us who are alive, for which we are grateful. We thank you, God, that you have taken us from near and far. You have, O God, caused us to be congregating this morning to celebrate the life of your son, George. To celebrate and to reflect, Almighty God, of all his kindness that he has done towards humanity. For his contribution, Almighty God, to community and to family. O God, it pleases you, Heavenly Father, in your divine wisdom to have taken him from all of us. Lord, whatever you have done, we may not understand. But what is done by thee, O God, is well done. We pray therefore, Father, that you will guide the proceeding of the day. We pray that by your Spirit you will inspire and encourage, especially those, God, who would be most intimately connected to your Son and who would have felt this loss in a deep way. May you, by your Holy Spirit, comfort them. May you, Lord, inspire every tribute that will be rendered. When a time for the word of God, we pray that you will inspire the one who will bring the word. So that at the end of it, Lord, it will be a moment of thanksgiving. It will be a time of understanding. And it will be a time of God when we are encouraged to go on living. Take charge of everything and everyone, now we pray, through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
I want to thank Bishop Milburn for praying this morning with opening prayer. At this time, we're going to have the first lesson, which we've taken from Ecclesiastes chapter 12, reading from verse 1 to verse 7. And this will be done by Anil and Yute, is that the name by the grandchildren?
The father who causes God and the mere child of God. They are afraid of heights and of terrible waves. When the autumn tree blossoms and the grasshopper is burning, the desire is called, the desire fails. For one man goes to his eternal home, and the mourners go about the streets. Remember your creator, before the silver cord is loose, or the gold bone is broken, or the pitcher is shattered at the fountain, or the wheel of the wheel broken at the well. Then the dust will return, so will the earth and was, and it was. Then the dust will return to earth and it was, and the spirit will return to God to the day. This is the word. This was one of the Lord, here this is a portion of God's word. We start by saying,
and we share.
are going to meet in the past. The rapture is coming.
Judgment. To the Bartley's family on the passing of Master George Bartley. It would have been a pleasure for me to be a part of this time as we celebrate, as we remember his life and give God thanks for what he has done in the lives of so many persons there in Wakefield. As you could recall, that Mr. Bartley brought tremendous joy and laughter to the Wakefield community by his jovial, courteous and friendly demeanor, one of generosity and love. And I want to say to both Jonathan and the rest of the family members and Miss Sissy, I want to say that God has been so good to all of us. Let us remember and live the legacy of a man who worked very hard. A man who never allowed hard work to stop him from enjoying the company of family, of community and friends. And so today, as we remember his life, may we give God thanks for what he has done in our midst as we share with Master George Bartley. I want to also remind the family members and relatives that God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in times of trouble. So in times of bereavement, God will be our strength. Not only is God our strength, but God will be our hope. He brings hope into the hearts of people because there is a resurrection. And the hope carries with it a sense of peace. Yes, he gives you peace in the midst of your storm. He gives you peace in the midst of your pain. He gives you peace in the midst of your grief. So trust in God. Rely on him. Embrace him. He said, call upon me and I will answer you. He said, he that cometh unto me, I will in no wise cast out. So take this moment as family and relatives to embrace God and to experience the goodness of God, even as you remember the life of a father, a grandfather, a great-grandfather, a friend. Yes, God has been good, and let us continue to celebrate his goodness as we remember the life of George Bartley. God bless you. Thank you for listening. And I trust that God will continue.
Our second lesson comes to us from Revelation chapter 22, reading from verse 1 to verse 7. And this will be done by Lionel Bartley, son of the deceased. trivial, worried that the rain will be coming soon and we need to get out of here quickly as possible. Is that clear to everybody? So we're looking between 2 minutes, no longer than that, for more trivial at this time, all right? So we will go in this order. The first one will be coming from German Spence, our permanent secretary in the Ministry of Agriculture, followed by Lieutenant Sandra Lawrence, His Worship the Mayor, Councillor Colin Ajo, and Angelica Barkley, for daughter, and one for Elaine Barkley, another daughter that somebody will be reading something from at this time. So at this time, we will have Mr. Spence to come.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
Although we are mourning at the time of the loved one, we have to rejoice in the Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, it is with mixed feeling that I stand here today to pay tribute to an outstanding man who has lived a good life. The Bible tells us, for all our days are passed away in thy wrath. We spend our days in a tale that is told. The days of our years are 70 years and 10. And if by reason of strength, they be 80 years. Yet, if their strength labor and sorrow, for it is soon cut off and we fly away. Mr. Barkley lived a full life, a good life too. What is most important is the way we live our lives. We should live our lives to honor God and do good to our fellow men. I can say today that Mr. George Barkley lived a good life. As I pay tribute today, I want to express sincere condolences to the family, especially his son, Councillor Jonathan Barkley, a good friend of mine and fellow councillor. He is one of the dedicated councillors at the Municipal Corporation, always willing and ready to rise to any occasion. So today, on behalf of the political directorate, which include, and we are all here, my deputy mayor, Councillor Donovan White, Councillor Harper from the Sherwood Division, and Dr. Foster, who is from the Ulster Spring Division, and we are expecting that Councillor Garth Wilkinson will join us a little later. I want to say that we all, and I should also include the administrative staff of the Trelawney Municipal Corporation that is headed by Mr. Andrew Harrison, we all express sincere condolences to you and the family. May God strengthen you. Thank you. Thank you.
not have come to a real meeting yet. But on behalf of the political caucus of People's National Party in the General Municipal Corporation, we wish to just tell Councillor Barty, although he knows how sorry he is that he has lost his father. It doesn't matter that he was 93. Even when we have them for 103, they still feel that they're gone too soon. I am here this morning because Councillor Barty is afraid. I don't know if you hear what I'm saying here.
Yeah.
Councillor Barty is not only my colleague, he is my friend. We have an extremely good relationship. And I told him on Wednesday, no matter what I have to do today, I must be here to support him. If his father is anything like what I know Councillor Barty to be, a man of service, a man of dedication, who I never had the pleasure to meet, he had a life well lived. All I can say to him is sleep on this apartment. Sleep and take your rest. Because on that great day, when the trump of God shall sound, he will be among the numbers. And if you want to be among the numbers, live like you. Amen? And I will leave you with this. We remain.
Train up the child in the way he should go. And when he
children, and grandchildren. Thanks be to Almighty God. Over 7 years ago, on the 14th of May, 2040, Brother George said yes to Jesus Christ and surrendered his life to his Maker and took the water baptism under the pastoral guidance of Reverend Owen Brown.
Brother Martin
was one of those active members, but he slipped quietly in his small corner, acknowledging the majestic power of God. Today, we are here to celebrate a life well spent. What good, my brother. Thanks for sharing your last 7 years with us. Sleep on. Death is just a transition from this world of trials, sickness, and heartache. For those we love, don't go away. They walk beside us every day. At sea, on earth, but always near. Still loved, still missed, and very near. Goodbye, my brother. Be at peace as you rest in the arms of your loving Savior. May the light of God perpetually shine upon you. Family, take courage. Be not afraid. The Lord your God is with you. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Shelters.
I can remember at 9 years old, I was hit by a car and had a broken leg. I was hospitalized. My father worked at ambulance. Every evening, my father was at the hospital for about 4 hours. Every evening, my father rode from ambulance to call me just to see me. I was another time diagnosed with appendicitis and was able in the hospital. The only person as a parent I saw at the hospital was my father. He was there every day. Every day my father rode his bicycle to find the hospital. My father teach me to drive Uncle Royce, to ride Uncle Royce's little bike. I don't know if anyone was willing, but I think to hold on whatever it is. He teach me to ride it. My father teach me to drive the tractor. And he was hungry. When my father was sick, I was always on the journey with my father. Open the door, my father. I want to say something, but I believe it. Dada, let me leave it.
Someone gave me a piece of sugar cane. I made the mistake of starting
frightened to go to their cave before I went home. My father fumbled, and I received one of the most severe spankings that I can remember. He was a disciplinarian. This helped mold me to become the parent that I am today. One other fond memory that I have about my father is whenever he gets my hand left over, no one else dared to name his father than me. If I was not at home, no one could touch him before I came home. He was also a creature of habit. Dad insisted that we pray before we went to bed and bid him an hour good night. Every morning, he would burst the curtains open and ask if we did not realize that it was time to wake up. He is gone now, and I am happy that he lived a long life. He left us with a lifetime of memories, and I will cherish for the rest of my days. Rest in peace, Dad.
Thank you.
share with us.
Good morning, church. Hello. Okay, I am here to do a musical tribute, and I was asked by Councillor Barkley. I come from foreign. Oh, you laugh. So a special musical tribute while we do the rose ceremony. While I have the opportunity, let me remind you, if you have not already done so, please to make peace with Almighty God through the Lord Jesus Christ today, because we don't know the day or the hour when our turn will come. Make it right with the Lord today. Those with the roses, please start your ceremony walking up now.
Thank you. Stephen Barnes Gilbert, Dada, Mass George, Papa, Uncle George, Barfoot, Jigo, otherwise called Babyface. Genesis 12, 1 to 3. The Lord had said to Abraham, go from your country, your people, and your father's household, to the land where I will show you. I will make you into a great nation. I will bless you. I will make your name great, and you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse, and all peoples on the earth will be blessed through you. Today we can say, our Father, our grandfather, our great grandfather, our great great grandfather is indeed blessed. The fact that he lived for 93 years is more than a blessing. I stand here today with mixed emotions to remember our father, grandfather, great grandfather, and great great grandfather. Being the first grandchild, the mother of his first great grandchild, and the grandmother of his two great great grandsons, give me an opportunity to experience and interact with him in different ways. What stood out mostly was his hard work, his dedication, and his love for his family, which he passed on to most of us. His warm smile, not to mention his signature laughter. Papa was a family-oriented person. His love for us could not be differentiated as he knows no boundaries. Today we salute you as the Honorable George Barton. You are indeed an honorable man, a disciplinarian, one who tells it like this. He was loved by the old and the young alike. Our house was home away from home. Or you could say it was the headquarters where all of us grew up as siblings. Even our friends were welcome to stay. He would never let anyone feel out of place. He was dedicated and hardworking, who took great interest in his job and the upbringing of his siblings. He would be up as early as 2 a.m. to ensure he was not late for work. He worked at the Hamlet Sugar Stage in Toronto, where he was one of the most outstanding truck drivers for 60 years. During those days, transportation was not easily accessible, so you would either have to walk or have your own transportation. Dada has his phone, his bicycle, which could be considered today as one of the top of the line cars. This was out of the reach of children. This was his only means of getting to work, and he would not allow us to use it as a car. One would see him cleaning down his bicycle after work, grease, oil, after which the padlock would be placed on his head. He enjoyed all meals. As a result, you will see him home by 10 or 11 during the days for lunch. He would ensure food was at the house, not to mention firewood to prepare the meal. One would see him bringing home tractor loads of firewood. There was this huge wood heap at the back of the house, as if he was competing with the one at the sugar estate. Papa was our doctor. He had different herbs planted beside of the house. He would tell us stories just to get us to consume these tea bushes. I remember one afternoon I stopped by just in time to see him picking some of his herbs. He said to me, "You know this?" I said, "No." He gave one of his signature laughters and said, "This is his palm in sugar leaf. He crushed it and said, "Sugar man." It was the bitterest thing I've ever tasted. And I was so mad. He was all, but he always found a way to make things feel easy. As children, I remember Thomas had a broken arm when he was about 6 years old. Papa ensured he was okay. He never left his side. During the time of his pain, he pushed on his arm and Thomas cried and cried, "Dada," but he never left Thomas' side until the cast was off. As kids growing up, we had to repeat the prayer, "Gentle Jesus, lead and guide," before going to bed. Boys had to be neatly groomed and brushed their hair. Girls clean and tidy. Master, as most would say, was not a troublemaker. He was a jovial and fun to be around person. Once he was around, then you would not stop laughing. He seemed not to have a care in the world. Once I heard a young man complaining about a meal that was prepared at his house, and the young man was caring about. But Papa simply said to him, "Nothing is wrong with the food that you eat. It's simply the mind that you have. That is what is going to do to your body." And the entire place erupted in laughter. Growing up as siblings, sometimes have disagreements. One afternoon, his daughter, Gabia, who predeceased him, she was standing on a stone. And her younger brother, at that time, came with a piece of cake that was frozen. And he said to her, "Come on for the stone so I can chop it with the cake." She refused to do so. So he insisted and chopped her on her toe. So she ran to Papa for rescue, thinking that Papa was going to leave for her something. All Papa said to her, "You know, go say machine on." And he dressed the tool and everything was back to normal. Bob, as was called by his friends, was known for drinking. The famous JB, one could say he was advertising the brand for the sugar state. He was not a drunkard. He would drink in the confines of his home. He would always be seen with his quarter wrapped around his hand, because this is the reason he got the name Aaron. If you were ever in his presence while drinking, he would say to us as children, "Come taste this man, it is good for the worms." One could also say he was a homeboy. If he was not at work or some function, he would either be at the police station paying W's on a Saturday, which he would have moral to accompany him. Otherwise, you would find him sitting on the veranda in his special chair. For all the breakfast, lunch, and dinner, he was a lover of practicing. They had to be overripe. As soon as I approached the door, you could hear him say, "Come sit right to some side and hand it some." And no matter how you were full, you had to taste what he was eating. He would be sitting right there, fast asleep, even snoring, and somebody would pass and call to him, and he wouldn't answer. On the second call, he would say, "Master, just sleeping." Then he would reply, "You're thinking of sleep?" If it was a female, he would then say, "Make sure to take off the pajama for the next year." Once Papa bought this wooden truck for Michael, he was so enthused with his truck. He pulled Michael on his new truck all the way to Congotown the next morning. Later, as years progresses, a few of us young adults had the opportunity of becoming his co-worker namely Michael, Jackie, Ari, and myself. And all of we made sure that we were taken care of, and everyone knew that we were related to him. So we could never ever be disrespectful, because he was highly respected, and he would not put up with any disrespect from anyone else. I can remember one lunchtime going out for lunch. Papa and his colleagues were joking, and he was talking about the money in his pocket. One person said to him, "All I'm going to do is to take all the money from you." Papa said, "Even if I drop down to him, I'll make sure that he drop on the side of the money in the bank. And if I don't carry my arm, you would find him with the most clean money. It is as if he had his own money machines. He would from time to time check up on his children, grandchildren, and great-grandchildren. Papa did not have money, but his love was more than enough. Favorite cousin was Tata. Whenever they got in an argument, Uncle Tata would always get upset and leave. After 2 days, if he did not see Tata, he would ask, "Sissy, you not see Tata?" And if she said no, then he would ask, "Ora, you see Tata?" And he would dare to find Tata, and they would have a dream. Then he would say to me, "Why are you always making a fair cousin?" Uncle Tata would say, "No worry yourself, man, you are right. Me study you, man, so far." The memories we have that we will always cherish as grandkids. Alain, my greatest memory or lesson from my grandfather is the fact that he took care and appreciated the little he had. Growing up, everyone knew Jigo and his bicycle and his kids. We knew we couldn't dare ask him for it when he was far too young, even if we were running errands from our home. We could never dare touch his bicycle. For me personally, this taught me how to appreciate the small things we have and to value and care for them. Katie, if there is one thing I knew about Dada, is that he took care of his home. One memory that stuck with me, after school I would find my way to my grandparents' house. When it was evening and no one came to pick me up, he would get on his bicycle and tow me all the way home. After seeing to it that I was safe and inside, he would say, "All right, later." Then he journeyed back to his home. The shared laughter when he was around will be most missed. As for Jamie, he would say to him whenever you take him to the doctor, "God bless your grandson." At Amden, Papa teach us to drive the tractor, and we, most of us became drivers from an early age. My last visit to him, he was saying to me that, "You know, I want to come to Montreal, come stay with you and go for a friend." And I said to him, "Papa, you know that I work almost every day." But he just wanted to come, even though he knew he could not come. And so this afternoon, I will stop here, because the memories of Papa will go on and on and on. So this afternoon I say, may his soul rest in peace.
What is for sure? Is there anything else you need to say? I stand here today as a very proud son of a man, his mother Sarah Innes and father Jonathan Bagley. In the year 1928, the 29th day of August, the 11th child of 16 children, they called him George Stephen Bagley. His friends called him Bafo, Jigo, Akin Parish, Johnny Kay, and Bad, and Babyface. He received his early education at the Wakefield Baptist Church, then move on to the Wakefield Elementary School. At age 16, he recognized that his father and mother needs help. He seeks employment at the Hamden Estate, where he works on all four farms: Tipton, Phoenix, Gates Valley, and Hamden, where he built a solid foundation around him. And I will tell you later about the solid foundation. Just keep your radio on. The main newscast will come to you. Don't touch that dial. We have some advertisement. Let us remember that COVID is still here with us. And as we move to the graveside and the afterpass, I ask of us to keep our distance. Let me also recognize our moderator, our pastor, and Pastor Philbert, Bishop Philbert, my colleague, his worship the mayor, Councilman Asia, Deputy Mayor, Councilor White, Councilor Albert, and Dr. Pastor. Also my good friend, Councilor God Wilkinson, sitting beside my wife. Let me recognize all of us who are here to celebrate the life of my father, especially our family members. The midday news comes to us from Babyface Radio Station, number 5. Baba, 11:34:39. If you wise, you will understand that. He was a very odd and dedicated worker, leaving his home as early as 2 a.m. to work in the morning. The management and other workers could depend on him to be the first driver to come through the gate each morning with a load of hay to start the sugar factory. As Michelle said, it was the top driver for Hamden. The first man to sit in any tractor in this state branches. And after the key was handed to him, no one else could sit in it, whether on the estate or in the field or lean on it. And no management could drive that tractor, only him. And that will continue from 1944 to 2004, 60 years of unbroken service. His hard work and dedication allowed two of his sons to be employed at Amden Estate, one of his daughter and his first granddaughter, Michelle, who remembers early with us. I must confess that when I was asked to represent the people in the Wakefield area, although being involved in so many things in Wakefield, when I move around and call by name, all that people could remember is it the Bartley that worked at Amden that used to bring us water or bring us wood? Or is it the Bartley that when it's crop time and the other driver refused to pull our cane because it was difficult to enter the cane field? Is it that Mr. Bartley that the estate would send to come to our rescue? Many of us as young men in the community at prayer time, we would go by prayer house hill, and Pastor don't know which hill I call prayer house hill. That's that steep hill going up to Mushet. The men, the young men of this community, they would go by for many reasons. To up onto the tractor to get a drive, or to pull a cane from the tractor, or to watch how it was so difficult for the drivers to go over the hill with one or two cars. But many would go there just to see George Bartley with his skill going over that hill with his three cars, and they would shout and they would cheer him as he go over the hill. We would stop by the intersection at prop time only to listen to the tractor coming down. And when we see the drivers, we would indicate to them, go on, go on. But when George Bartley is coming, we would shout and say, give me something, man, give me something. And for the men inside here, no one we talk about, he would go down in the gearbox of the tractor. And if the tractor has 10 years or 15 years, he would bench them out to us, and we would cheer, and we would laugh. George teach me how to love and to forgive. When I passed my exam to go to technical school in Montego Bay, because time was hard and difficult, he asked the estate At that time, they had a bus that was carrying the staff children to school in Montego Bay. He asked the management if I could drive with them to school. One supervisor quickly objected. Three worker children cannot drive with staff children. My father said, now, supervised and sent me to school. When the time was come for that supervisor to leave the estate, I finished school and I was a professional draftsman, preparing building plan. That supervisor had nowhere to lay his head. He went to my father and asked my father if he could ask me to draw a house plan for him. And my father said, forgive him. Do it for him. I did it. And from there I learned how to forgive and to love people. He was a community man, never involved in the law. He played cricket for his community. And at festival time, he would be a part of the team known as the Jamboo. He would dance tango. And I can remember recently, Dr. Shepherd traveled all the way from Kingston because he wanted to know something about tango and kumina. And was asking for George Barkley because she learned that he was the man who could tell her about tango and kumina. A friend to her, don't matter what the circumstances are, the situation, how sad one may be, he will keep you laughing all day, even when you are going home, even when you reach home and sleeping, you will be laughing in your sleep. And the people love to see at any function slowly coming on his bicycle. And many people thought that his bicycle was the first one he had had. His first bicycle was given to me in 1974, when his brother Roy went to Canada and leave a under 50 with him, which he arrived to buy no more bicycle. And he called that under 50 Hatman. Then his true love bicycle came, given to him in 1988 by his son Michael, which he said recently before he passed, I have never changed a tire on this bicycle. He loved that bicycle so much, always having to keep in the house. And one night, his wife, Miss Sissy, decided that the bicycle would not sleep in the house that night. George sleep on the veranda with the bicycle. And when she leave for United States of America, each Eli, the bicycle was by his bedside in the room. He almost passed out one day when he looked on the veranda and the bicycle was not there. Only to hear that Daddy Fox take away his bicycle. He retrieved it. He started his solid foundation that he built around him. When his mother and my grandmother were good friends. But my grandmother refused to send my mother to school regularly because she did not want the boys to talk to her. So she hid her at home. My father was driving a tractor carrying water for the field workers. And the main area, they call it the yard. So George, he would take water to his mother and my grandmother in the field to make sure they are out there in the field. And then he did not tell them a lie. He said to them, I will then take water to yard. His mother and my grandmother believed that he was talking about taking water to big yard where all the workers gathered and was having lunch, not knowing that my father was taking water to my mother's yard. Then comes the first section of that foundation, and my brother is here. Then he continued to take water to yard, and my second sister came. And he continued, then comes I. He stopped and no fear coming home from Pilsner. And he made that fourth section of the foundation. And so we have that fully four section of a foundation. He continued to build on the foundation until he decided that he's going to settle down. And in 1986, the 15th of March, he married Eunice Tompkinson. This union produced 5 children. After they have been for from 1960. I could be the last child, but God did not have it so. In 1957, the tractor that he was driving overturned on him, and that tractor was carrying a dangerous chemical called acid, and it was burned all over his body, and some of those burners sank, which take him to his grave. He had a second accident. As Michelle said that, he would distribute wood in those days, stove was not the norm. So passing each home, he would drop off a piece of wood so that people would have it to cook their dinner. One day he was cutting up some wood to take home, and the axe cut his leg. That also take him to his grave. I want to say thanks to Nurse Burnett, who have assisted us, and the members of the Mayfield Health Clinic, who have assisted him during this time. George was a happy father of 13 children, and they come in this model. Came 1952. I come in 1955. Fred, 1956. Valsi, 1956. Monty, 1958. Pearl, 1958. Paulette, 1960. Han, 1961. Karen, 1962. Michael, 1964. Jackie, 1966. Ari, 1968. Angela, 1974. 34 grandchildren. 39 great grandchildren and 2 great grandchildren. Wife unites one brother, nieces and nephew, and the old Wakefield family. Loretta Linson asks her one day, "Daddy, why, Mommy, why do God take Daddy away?" Loretta Lynn answered, "Son, listen to me. Your daddy always prayed to God, and God took him from us. Son, you cannot go to your daddy. Son, your daddy cannot come back to you, but you can go to your daddy. My little nieces and nephew, I want you to know today, on the 12th of September, I took my daddy, Johnny, to the emergency room. On the 14th, I took him a second time. Johnny looked at him because he had not spoken strongly or one could understand because his health was going. And Johnny wanted to test how he's feeling. And Johnny looked at him and he said, "Who is this?" And loud and strong, he said, "This is my son, Fred." Johnny was shocked. I say that to say this. He was conscious up to the point of death. And I believe that he had answered the calling of God. And he is somewhere in the bosom of sweet deliverance. I say thanks to Dr. Godfrey and the workers of the Trelawney Fire Department who have assisted us. George is no longer with us, but he's somewhere around God's throne. And I know my sisters and brothers, family members and friends, well wishers, that one day we will see George again sitting around the throne of God, talking with David and Jacob and Isaac, that we have shared here on earth. I say to you, my Father, you have lived a good life. You have fought a good fight. You have finished and you have kept the faith. Laid up for you treasures in heaven. My family members, if you are going through difficult times, this church that we actually lay in the name of our Father, and this pastor, they are here to usher us into the arms of sweet deliverance, where we will see our Father again. Welcome, church. Mississippi, we love you. My sisters and brothers, I love you. God bless you.
Yeah. the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah. He that shed blood and went down to hell and took the keys of hell and of death. Hallelujah! Joy of the mansion, let's show no more open. He went to shed down from heaven, tell the word of God.
last month as it was known. And I can very well amazing days. It is an ending the Bible says that's amazing that the day is far. It's my good part and friend here in the long time.
Thank you. Thank you. just look and move. Yeah.
Jesus!
So just look and move so that others can move. Because of the rain, we need to move.
Dada!
Hello, friend!
Dada,
friend! The casket is been open for a very short time. So I ask you all those friends who want to have a last stone, go and do so now. And please... French, let me ask you again. Just move, look and go and move. Don't stand up and block the others. Just look and move.
Benson, you see?
All right, we are okay.
Carry over there again now.
Yes, we have to.
Where did you go?
All right, we're closing.
You ready? All right. That thing need to move, man. Yeah, move and steal it. I got that, man.
That man, drop the man in, man.
Yeah, man.
Oh, oh.
I'm going to ask friends who are coming by the board. Yes, I'm going to ask you guys to join us. Yeah. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Now is Christ risen from the dead, and has become the first fruit of them that slept, and in him shall all be made alive. We brought nothing into this world, neither shall we take anything out of this world. The Lord gave, and the Lord has taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Spray, what next cast is something they want to go for it.
Marie, get next spray.
Okay, I'm going to ask you to release the casket. No, not release the casket. You take your folder from the casket and let me proceed.
Marie. Just a second, we're going to wait for a read. They want to put it.
Alright. Crash out. Jojo, that's the name.
Just one. Huh? Oh, no, you have a
child, yeah.
all flesh is grass, and all the glory of man is not as the grass of the field. The grass withers, and the flowers thereof fall away. Yes? And the flowers thereof fall away. After labor comes rest, after struggle cease, after life people fever, this last sleep. And now, since it has pleased Almighty God to take away from this life the soul of our dear brother, we therefore commit to the ground, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust, and we leave his soul with God, his Maker and Savior, in hope of the resurrection to eternal life, which is in Jesus Christ our Lord, who died, was buried, and is risen again, and who shall come back for his sins. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, we thank you for your goodness and love to us. We thank you, Lord, we don't own our lives. You own them because you have made us. But Lord, you own them doubly because you have not only made us, but you have paid the price for our sins. So you own us and then you bought us again. What a glorious God, and we give you praise. Hallelujah. And we give you honor. And we give you all the glory, Almighty God. We thank you for the life of our late brother, Brother Bantley. Lord, as you have taken him from us at this time, we just want to commit his body to the ground and his spirit to you, Almighty God, who gave it. We pray for those who we have left tomorrow. So many big, strapping sons and lovely daughters and his darling wife. Lord, we are committing them into your hands. We pray for your peace. We pray for your comfort. We pray for your sustaining grace. And more importantly, God, we pray that all of them will look to you, Jesus, as they confess their sins unto you and surrender their life and become your children. So now we commit the whole family into your hands. We commit the church family into your hands. We commit all who are in us, are related to him in some way or the other. We commit them into your hands. Bless your people, Almighty God. We want the family members to know that nothing at all, nothing can separate us from the love of God, which is in Jesus Christ our Lord. Not height, not depth, not principalities, not powers, not things to come, things present, nor any creature in all of heaven and earth can separate us, hallelujah, from the wonderful love of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, in whose name we pray and they go on say, amen. Amen. Workman, you can't get to work and do your thing. But you see anybody's classmates? No, what's wrong with you?
Thank you. Thank you. can go now.
Special occasions, call this number 431-3908. That is 431-3908. That is 431-3908. Out of Malibu, Jamaica. Yeah. Come here.
Thank you very much for our lives. I want to thank you for the life of our late brother. He is an angel of the other side. I want to thank you, God, that he's an angel. He is not in the body. His spirit has gone to be with you. When you call him, he will bring him with you. And so, Lord, I want to thank you for those who are around. May you bless them all, even as we are about to head home for different areas. And so, may the blessings of God, the Father Almighty, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you all from this evening and evening forevermore. Everyone say,
because he lives, I can face tomorrow. Because he lives, all fear is gone. Because I know thank you.
Hey!